Hey, hello everyone. Welcome to another week in lockdown and therefore another wild art session. For my part, I'm going to be starting a little bit of work again from next week. So I'm going to try and keep up with the sessions, but bring them to fortnightly as opposed to weekly, just so I've got the right balance of things in my own life between work and recreational art and, of course, family, including just time with my baby girl. Okay, this week we're going to have a go at a panther chameleon, which is a really amazing-looking creature with so many cool features. Those eyes and the tail, the hands, the coloration, just kind of everything about them is amazing, and there's so many variations on this that you can do. So at the end I'll show you a few more pictures of panther chameleons so you could try maybe a different coloration. Okay, so sort of similar materials that we're going to need. That first bit of cards, the main bit of cards, which cereal box side. A second bit of card, which can be any kind of card, doesn't matter, but the same size as your first bit of card. The usual in terms of water, and we'll mostly be using a medium brush. I think perhaps I'll just be using medium brush, but if you have a smaller one as well, that's no bad thing. We're going to use two bits of sponge, so one for one set of colours and one for another. Pencil for a bit of outlining, scissors for a bit of cutting, so we'll use the stencil technique again. And then two palettes. The first palette, I've got black and green. And the second palette, we've got kind of all the colours, because we need them to make this chameleon kind of rainbow coloured. So maybe it's sort of a thank you NHS chameleon. You could use it as that and give it to maybe a relative or a friend who works for the NHS. So we've got red, yellow, blue, green, black and white. We'll be using a bit of each of those, particularly these two, to get our sort of main background colour for the chameleon in the first place. Okay, cool. Ready to go. Okay, so starting with a sort of, reasonable size of sponge, because we don't need to be delicate at all with this first stage. Our main bit of card and that first palette with the black and the green. I'm going to just get a bit of a mix of the black and the green, but not worry about properly mixing them together. And let's just start moving that around into our background. And this is going to be sort of, a leafy background that we'll do the chameleon in front of. And it being quite dark is a good thing, because we want to get some decent contrast with this, and the chameleon's going to be fairly light generally in its tone, so we want it to really stand out on this background, and so having a darker background is the way to go, really. But I'm doing it here so that in some places it's darker and some places I've got more of the green, and I think at the end I'll bring in a few areas of brighter green still. But for now, let's just spread that around, kind of as it is. Get a full coverage. We want a full, absolute full coverage of this mix of tones. It's a bit like camo, isn't it? Camouflage gear. But that's what I guess this piece is all about, is something that camouflages. Although, having said that, in this particular case, and you should look up some images of the panther chameleon, it's pretty stunning, and I think it does have the ability to camouflage, but also has the ability to display these amazing colours as well, and I've got to assume that's to attract a mate, or maybe it's to scare off other individuals. Okay, just going to take a little bit more of the green. And I'm just going to bring that into a couple of areas. So we've got slightly brighter tones in a couple of areas. So let's do that bottom left and maybe up to the right as well. And as you can quite imagine, just looking at this, it's going to take a little while to dry. But in that time, we're going to be doing the outline of our chameleon. Okay, I'm going to bring, you know what? I'm going to dare to do this, just a tiny bit of the white and green. So I'm doing this off camera. So I've got, yeah, a bit of white and green. I'm going to now just mix those together just a bit on the palette. So I've now got that slightly lighter tone. And I'm just going to bring that down into a couple of the areas where I've got the green already. So just to show that there's a couple of bits where it's slightly lighter. A bit more light is coming through, or a bit more light is shining down on those areas. And that's probably about right. We don't want to go too far with this. Okay, I reckon that will do. Right, let's leave that to dry for, well, it's going to take a little while, isn't it? So we'll. Okay, we're going to outline our chameleon now on our second bit of card, which is the same size as the first. If you guys want to find your own outline of chameleon, that's absolutely fine. In fact, that's great. Or you can just sort of loosely copy what I'm doing here. So I want my chameleon, I think just compositionally this works, to go from kind of bottom left up towards the right. So the head will be up this end, tail down this end. We obviously don't want it to take up the whole picture because we want to have a bit of the environment around it. So I've given myself a loose kind of oval in the middle of where I'd like the chameleon to be. So ideally kind of not further than there or there. So I've got enough environment around it. So we can reasonably assume that our stick branch that the chameleon is on is going to kind of come up, but maybe deviating a little bit from that midline. So something like that. Okay, how to start. So let's start with just the body part, and that itself is going to be sort of an oval. So this is the main trunk of the body. And then at the tail end comes out, and the curve of the tail. I think we'll have this coming up and in front of the branch, as it is. That curves in, but we'll be doing that, getting that detail in a little bit later. Okay, something like that. Right, back leg. There's the thigh. There's the sort of calf element. And then the foot, we'll worry about the detail of that a bit later on. Okay, now, so for the front leg, let's come to around there. So that's the sort of shoulder part around there. Upper arm part, lower arm. And for now, we're going to get the branch in a bit later. We won't actually be cutting out the shape of the branch because it will just confuse things to do so. But it helps to have it for now just to figure out the shape of our chameleon. Okay, so we'll not worry about the back legs, the ones sort of on the other side of the body. We'll just stick to the ones on this side of the body. Keep it fairly simple. Okay, so now for the head. So with the panther chameleon, it's got a fairly impressive, I guess you could call it crest? I'm not sure exactly what you'd call it. You can tell me what you'd call it. Okay, so it comes down to sort of there. Okay. I have got a photo in front of me that I'm using as at least vague reference. I'm not doing exactly what's on it, but close to it. I need to think about whether that's coming out far enough. Not sure. I might just bring it out just a touch more. Okay. And when it comes to it, although we're not going to be doing this, the eye is kind of around there. But yeah, we won't be cutting that out. Okay, so at this stage, I want to more clearly define the outline of just the chameleon. Let's forget about the branch for now and none of the details inside, because we'll be cutting out the main outline of this. So I'm just going to more clearly define it off camera. and then yeah, cut it out, and you'll see kind of what we end up with. But it's not going to worry about the branch for now, and no details on that. Okay, there's my more clearly defined outline. So I've just corrected a few things on the legs, and I've made sure I've got space to cut into there, for example. So you want your outline to be fairly clear. So yep, just going to cut this. And there we go. So we've got two elements, the bit that I've cut out. And actually, I think on this occasion, we won't need this bit at all. So let's put that to the side. And this is what we're going to need to get an initial tone and colour of our chameleon onto our background. And then we'll be working the detail into that. Okay, I think we're ready to have a go at getting the beginnings of our chameleon on there. So I've got my cutout, I've got my background, and I can now think about where I'd like it to be. So it could be sort of more diagonally up to the right, could have it more up there. I think I'm going to bring mine into this sort of area down here. So I've got the brightness of the background vegetation still kind of out to the right of it. Okay, I've got my second bit of sponge, and I'm going to go into the yellow and the red. And we're going to have this as our sort of background colour to the chameleon, but we're then going to be getting in blues and greens and other tones as well. Okay, so as ever, make sure you're pressing down well with your stencil. And then sponge in, so you're sort of sponging over the edge of the stencil. So the sponge itself is sort of spanning both the inside and the stencil, the card itself, and that way you should get these nice crisp lines. Don't try and sort of push the paint up under the stencil, because then you won't get that crisp line. Right, I'm going to bring in just a bit more yellow now, I think, as I work my way back. Make sure I get into there. Okay, that's going pretty well. So yeah, I think a bit more yellow still, because I quite like to just tone back from a sort of more reddish orange at the front to a more yellowish orange at the back, and just generally getting a transition of tone is quite satisfying. Okay, I'm going to bring a little bit more yellow into that middle region just for now, maybe particularly up over the top, and then I'm going to go back to a slightly more reddish at the back. You guys do whatever you feel like really for this. And at the end we're going to have a look at other colorations you could go with, and maybe even repainting your existing chameleon or having a go at a whole new one. Okay, so this is going to need, again, a few minutes to dry, so good chance to do something else. Let's have a break. Okay, let's have a look. Cool, that's a good beginnings. Right, we need to give that a good few minutes to dry. Okay, now that's pretty much dry. We're just going to now define a few areas slightly more clearly. I'm going to take a bit of the black paint and just water it down. So mix in a bit of water, not too much, because we don't want to just be dribbly and non-existent. Okay, wipe off the excess. Okay, so we now just need to sort of define where a few of the lines of the chameleon are. So let's do this back leg first. Wipe off a bit more excess. Come up from there to kind of the knee, and then back along to show you where the thigh is. Okay, and the thigh comes up kind of like that. Okay, that's the back leg. Let's go back and define the tail. So we need to come in from this lower line, and then we start to thin off the tail as we go along. Come up and along, basically spiraling inwards and making the spiral thinner as we go in to about there. So that's about right. I might darken that up just a little bit now. So I can see it a bit more clearly. Okay, it's the tail. Right, now the front arm. Front leg, possibly. It's up to there. Forearm comes in. And the upper part of the arm, like that. Okay, and finally a couple of aspects of the head. So let's start with the mouth, which comes from the front, but just sort of down from that top part there. Curves back. And I might just change the angle a little bit and have it coming down a bit from there. Okay, that's about right, roughly. Okay, and now a couple of aspects of the eye. So the first is sort of the bigger circle, which is the almost the joint of the eye, I suppose, the bit that can turn and look in any direction, which is pretty phenomenal, isn't it? It's one of just many crazy attributes of the chameleon. There's so many unique things about the chameleon. Okay, and then in the middle of that, so you can, depends where you want your chameleon to be looking, down or up or to the side. Okay, so I might do, this is now the pupil, or basically sort of the actual seeing part of the eye, which is quite small, so I might have mine slightly more towards the front, just that sort of size, like a dot in the middle of your bigger circle, and I'm just going to darken that up. That can be quite careful with this, so just use the very edge of your brush. This aspect can be full black. Okay. Right, we're now going to introduce just a little bit of shadow to a few places. So I'm going to take the black and mix in a bit of red, so we've got more of a brownish colour, basically. Okay, which is a darker tone than what we've currently got on the chameleon. Right, so I think about where a few areas of darkness are. I'm going to define the lower lip of the chameleon. Get a line along there and then just shade down from that a little bit. I'm going to shade along here, so the lower part, but probably keeping that bottom edge a bit lighter just so it's still clearly defined. Up to there. Shade underneath the crest, forwards like that. And then just slightly more clearly show the back of the head. And then an aspect of the crest continues in front of the eye, down towards the very end. Okay, and then the eye itself, I'm going to just shade in a little bit on the underside of it. This is all with that brownish colour, which is a bit of red and black. You want to make sure it's not too dark. So if you have a little try of what you've done and you think it's too dark, mix in a bit more red. Okay, so we need a little bit of shading on the underside of the belly. Again, I'm not going quite to the very edge because I want to keep that well defined. And often there is just a little bit of light coming from behind to show the lower edge of something. Okay, little bit along the part of there, a little bit underneath the thigh there. Possibly a little bit up from the thigh there. Okay, and then there's not really much for the tail, actually. I think it's shaded enough, so I'm not really going to do much there. Maybe just a little bit going down along the underside there. Okay, make that a bit more 3D. Okay, and finally I'm going to do, this is going to start marking out where a particular area of pattern is along the chameleon's body. So just a little bit of brushwork along, two thirds up really, or a third down from the top of the body. Bring that all the way along to join the neck of the chameleon. Okay, that's enough for that. Okay, while we've got this brown, brownish colour, let's just jazz it up a bit. So mix in a bit of blue, a bit more red, and a bit of white. And you can start to see the brown, and you can start to see the makeup of it, so that this particular brown needs a bit more red. Okay. Right, we're going to use this colour to start outlining our branch. Okay, so the branch needs to come underneath that leg. So I'm doing the lower part of the branch first, and then it's going to be grasped or clasped by this hand, so I'll come kind of on the underside of that. And once I get to here, I think I will divide my branch. So I'm going to have a bit coming down there, and then there'll be a bit going further up. Okay, so let's just finish that lower edge, so carry that one down to there. Okay, we'll do the upper edge of the branch now, so in and underneath the chameleon, through and past the front arm, and then once we get to here, I think I've decided that I'm going to divide out, maybe have another division there. You can play around with the shape of your stick however you please, really. It's whatever you think looks good. Right, let's fill that in with this brown, and we'll be doing some highlights on it a little bit further on. So you can see often what I'm doing is outlining something first, being happy with my outline, and then I fill it in. Okay, leave that there for now. Right, we're going to start getting some of the other colours into our Panther Chameleon now. And actually they have almost stripes. So, you know, it struck me that could almost be better named the Tiger Chameleon, but they are the Panther Chameleon, so stick with that. Right, we're going to do some blue first, and our first stripe effectively with the blue. Let's start from just behind the neck of the chameleon and come down. You can go off in various directions if you want, so through that middle tone we've got there, and then down towards the arm. Okay, and we'll do our second one, leave a decent gap behind it. Again, come through that middle area, and then down, and we'll snake down through the belly to there. Go further back again, for a bit of a gap. It's quite nice to have these sort of stripes dividing out and then rejoining, and yeah, just doing various slightly interesting things down through there. Okay, I might do for this one and make it just a single stripe rather than with the divisions. Those a bit more vibrant. Okay, and then all the way back along the tail, and this will help define the shape of the tail and show that it is spiraling around. A little bit along the tops there. Okay. This is quite like the tiger of the tail of a tiger, in that you get these fairly evenly spaced stripes going along it. Okay, work our way all the way towards the inside. Okay, that's good for that. Right, I'll do a few of these stripes just along the legs as well. Make sure your arches, the arch of the stripes, follows the the shape of the leg. So here it's showing the curve of the leg across there. That's good for sort of the calf effectively of that leg, and here it's curving like that, showing the shape of the thigh. And that's what you find with stripes, that they follow the shape of that part of the body. So again, for this one at the front here, it'll curve over like that. So you're trying to imagine what the shape is of that part of the body, be it the trunk or be it one of the limbs or even the face, and therefore what will the stripes look like. And then the stripes really help to show what that shape is. Okay, we're going to do just a little bit at the front now. So along the crest, a similar sort of idea, but maybe almost you can see sort of zigzaggy going back and forth. A little bit down the front, in front of the eye, and then just a few bits along the head. And with this, you can be quite creative, really. There's no sort of right or wrong way to be approaching it. But as ever, avoid doing too much. It's another kind of less is more sort of thing, I guess. Down through there. Okay, I think that's enough for that tone of blue. So I'm going to wash off most of that, but then I'm going to bring in some of my white and really lighten it up. That sort of level. Okay, I can feel that there's too much paint on the brush, so I use my t-shirt and wipe off the excess. Right, let's come in with that now. Okay, I'm going to use this lighter blue on just the top parts of the blue stripes that I've done. So let's start down at the left. Just do a little bit on the upper part of those stripes. So trying to think where the light's coming from, and I think the light's coming from above as it normally would. So you want to show that it's brighter on the top part of those stripes. Same for the leg, so just the top part of the stripes, probably finish there. A bit more white mixed in. And you can be quite sort of dotty with your approach, as in little sort of dabs of the brush, because actually the chameleon has all these little scales that are quite well defined as dots across its body. So sort of do those little dots into the areas of blue that you've already done. Just a little bit here, because a lot of that is in shadow. Forwards. Okay. Right, that's pretty much it for the blue, except this amazing stripe that the panther chameleon has across the middle part of its body. So we're going to use the brown line that we had there as our reference. I'm going to start at the left. And again, just lots of little dots to come above that brown line going along the body. through what we've already done. And it comes all the way up to just the neck. It doesn't go beyond that. Okay, I'm going to work a little bit more white into a few areas there. Right, I think that will do. Right, so we've got two more little bits on the head to use this lighter blue on. So a bit to define the lips, and then a bit to define the outline of the eye. Okay, so the lips come above, and that's a bit light, let's just wipe off a bit of the excess there, above the line that I've done for the chameleon's mouth. So try and keep that darker line that you've already got. Come all the way to the front. And then same underneath. This is quite delicate, so you might want to use the pencil crayon for this part, if you've got one to hand. Okay, that's it for the mouth. And now, just very carefully around the pupil, or the main eye of the chameleon. If you go over the black, you can always put some black back down into that. Okay, we're gonna bring in some light yellow now, so we need to wash off the brush thoroughly. Make sure this is gonna be nice and light and bright. Okay, let's take some of the yellow. Mix in some white, the pristine white. Okay, that should do the job. Okay, so with this, I want to do several things. Firstly, I want to show that the back of the chameleon is slightly ridged, so we're going to do some little lines coming along that main back of the chameleon all the way along to the front. Quite tricky to do those, isn't it? And then we'll do a few just along the back of the tail, but don't worry about going too far because the tail's sort of too delicate really for us to worry about doing too much of that. Okay, that's one thing for with the yellow. We're also going to bring some yellow dots down into our body, but avoiding the blue. So in each of the sections where there isn't blue, bring in a few of those light yellow dots up to the neck. And then a few beneath your kind of white line. I'm just sort of showing that the belly sticks out a little bit more there. Okay, and equally do a few in the sections of the legs in between the blue. So around there, and a few this front part. Just a very few, that will do. Okay, and then equally I'm going to come to the front of the head now, and I want to properly define this top line of the crest. So I'm gonna do my dots coming down into the red, so either side of the blue, but along that whole ridge, and that just highlights that nicely. So then let's come up over the eye and do the same in between the blue in front of the eye, all the way down to the very front there. Okay, I'm gonna do just a little bit up over the top of the curve of the eye, just to sort of effectively highlight that, tiny bit under. Okay, that's fine for that. And then I'm going to mix in just a little bit of red, actually, so I don't want to be quite as vibrant as this for the last little bit. Okay, so underneath, around here, we're going to do just a few lines coming forwards. But not too many. Can you see just a very few to the front? So these are lines rather than dots, and it's just a different texture on the chameleon underneath the mouth. Okay, be careful not to do too much. Right, I think that's fine. Okay, I'm going to do the lighter tone on the branch, and then we're going to finish up with just a few highlights, but we're nearly there. Okay, so we need a sort of lighter brown, really, don't we? So brown is a mix of blue, red, and yellow. We want to lighten it up. And that will do. You get so many different tones of brown, and it's not too important what sort of exact tone of brown you come out with, as long as it's vaguely brown. Okay, so let's come along the top line, and mix in a bit more red actually. Taking that brown is quite working. Okay, top line of our branch, and do similar sort of division of ridges like we just did under the chameleon's mouth. And come up along this one. And top line of this one. I'm going to do the bottom line with the same tone, just to mark out the shape of the branch. But then I'm going to lighten it up, so let's bring in a bit more white, and we're just going to do the brightest bit. So I've got to think where the light's hitting, maybe a tiny bit through the body of the chameleon, so maybe a tiny bit across this top line, and then certainly along here. Often I wipe off the excess on my shirt. You might kind of catch me doing that from time to time. For you guys, if you've got a rag or something else at the side to wipe off the excess paint, often you feel as though you've just got a bit too much on the brush and you need something to just wipe a bit of that off onto. And some bit of material is the easiest way to do that. Okay, I'll leave that there. Okay, final highlights. So, if you've got a smaller brush, great. If not, this might be a moment for the pencil crayon. Our first important highlight is going to be the eye itself, and we're just going to do the tiniest dot down into that black to show the light shining down onto that. Okay, that's all. Right, we can go back to our medium-sized brush now. And do a few highlights with the white. Okay, so I'm going to do just a little bit, I think, on the upper lip. Coming along the front. I reckon that's enough. Okay, a little bit again just along the top of the crest, but just quite sparing. Really helps it to stand out to get these final highlights in. And then just a little bit for the same reason along the back, maybe catching just a few more of those spikes going back. Okay. Just do a tiny bit along the top of that leg, a tiny bit along the top back of that leg to show that they are catching the light more as well. Right, definite danger of fiddling, so I think I'm going to leave it there. What I'd suggest you guys could also do a little bit of is a few more kind of near close-up leaves, so maybe some kind of down here or some coming off the branch ends up there. And then the main other thing to try would be to give this a second go, but with a completely different colour of chameleon. So maybe purples and blues, maybe more different shades of green. And in a moment, I'm going to show just a few more photos of panther chameleons so you can see just what incredible diversity there is among them. But yeah, have a go at this. And of course, as ever, I'd love to see your results. And I'm going to be now doing these sessions every 2 weeks. So you've got plenty of time to have a go at this one and have a go at some other things as well. And yeah, please keep sending me your results. Right, hope you're all doing really well and enjoying all the good things that we can be enjoying right now. There are silver linings. And yeah, see you all soon.